Hey guys, so Young Justice. You guys have been requesting this one like crazy, so let's dive in and explore some facts about this super cool hero team. I'm Sasha Wood, and these are the top 10 facts about Young Justice. Number 10. The comic team Young Justice first appeared in Young Justice The Secret No. 1 in 1998, with a lineup of Robin, Superboy, and Impulse. However, this was a one-shot story that led to a later appearance in the Justice League miniseries World Without Grown-Ups. It is here that they discovered their base, Happy Harbor. After this adventure, the boys decide to form the team officially. Number 9. The Young Justice TV show that first aired from 2010 to 2013 was seen as a great triumph for DC animation. It returned them to a pinnacle of balancing dark mature storytelling mixed with family-friendly elements that some felt hadn't been seen since the end of the DCAU. However, the show was abruptly cancelled, with rumors swirling that a lot of it had to do with the fact that while popular, the show had failed to attract its intended demographic, namely young boys. Why it was trying to hit this demographic was because they would buy the toys. It turned out that Mattel, the toy line, was funding the show. However, the attraction of a larger and more female demographic ultimately meant that the toys did not sell as projected, and Mattel pulled their funding, leaving the show without backers to encourage the network to pick it up for a third season. Number 8. The television series was a fusion of the 60s Teen Titans and the 90s Young Justice comic runs. Some homages can be noted in the first lineup of the team, that being Robin, Kid Flash, and Aqualad, which was the debut lineup of the first appearance of the Teen Titans in The Brave and the Bold No. 54. The reason Young Justice was chosen as a name was because creators felt the title best embodied the concept they wished to convey. Having a good author can help you convey what you want, which brings us to number 7. Beloved comic and sci-fi author Peter David wrote a significant portion of the Young Justice comic series, and was enthusiastically approached to pen some episodes for the TV series. His episode credits included Secrets, Insecurity, Bloodlines, and Intervention. At the time of this recording, he has been approached to pen some episodes for the upcoming season 3. Number 6. Young Justice appeared in a crossover episode of Teen Titans Go entitled Let's Get Serious. This was where the satirical version of the Titans made fun of their own team's lack of direction and mature storytelling elements, resulting in the team getting even more serious than Young Justice.
If we can't be serious about being superheroes, then who?
Which, if you've seen the show, you know is difficult.
What is so bad about being a little silly from time to time?
Back to comics for number 5. The Young Justice team from the comics was disbanded in 2003 during a much maligned crossover event, Titans/Young Justice Graduation Day. The end result was the team getting broken and split into two new teams formed of a combination of the two previously mentioned teams. Also, some people died, but they didn't stay dead. These new teams were the Teen Titans, a new iteration, and the Outsiders. Speaking of new versions of things brings us to number 4. The Young Justice television show introduced a new Aqualad, who was so beloved he made the rare leap from television into the comics. Kind of. Aqualad in the comics is not the same one from the show. The comic version is named Jackson Hyde, and he has a significantly different backstory and character arc. Will Calderon himself ever be in an upcoming iteration of the comics? Who knows? Only time will tell. Number 3. The Young Justice TV show takes place in continuity on one of the many Earths of the DC universe, specifically Earth 16. It was thought at the time that Earth 16 was an untapped universe. However, by that point it was too late, and the show simply ignored the continuity that was supposed to exist on this Earth. Previously, Earth 16 had been home to the Super Sons. It was later explained away as Young Justice being a fictional series on the original Earth 16. Because yes, people get really nitpicky about these things. Being a fictional series, perhaps it too was part of our number 2. Hashtag justice for Wally. For those who watched Young Justice, they're probably already familiar with this hashtag. For others, let me explain. Wally West's fate was left rather ambiguous at the end of season 2, which ended on, while not quite a cliffhanger, what was clearly an opening for more episodes. However, the early 2010s was not a good time for Wally. He just flat out vanished from the time stream. Well, he's back now, and if the teasing by the Young Justice voice actor is any indication, then he'll be back for season 3. Justice for Wally indeed. Which of course ties right into our number 1. The television show was saved by passionate fan support and equal creator passion. When the second season of the series was released on Netflix, one of the show's creators, Greg Wiseman, tweeted out for a third season, saying that it could be possible if enough people viewed the show and bought the DVDs/Blu-rays. Some of the voice actors also made similar pleas, and the viewership numbers were not lost on Netflix. And with much prodding and lobbying on the part of both fans and creators, a third season was commissioned. This new season was announced on November 3rd, 2016, and is set to air hopefully sometime in 2017. So those are the top 10 facts about Young Justice. Are you guys fans? Are you excited for season 3? Let me know down below. As always, keep leaving requests for even more nerdy lists. We love fulfilling them here on Top 10 Nerd. I'm Sasha Wood. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and of course subscribe so you never miss another nerdy list. See ya!